Hello everyone! Today we're going to read Never Tickle a Tiger by Pamela Butchert, illustrated by Mark Bartavant. Never Tickle a Tiger! Izzy was forever shuffling and jiggling, squirming and twitching, wriggling and fiddling.She just couldn't help it. It happened at home. Izzy, stop playing with your peas, said Dad. At school, Izzy, stop painting your pigtails, said Miss Bathurst. At Grandma's, Izzy, stop knotting my knitting, said Grandma.And as for at parties, well, Izzy, stop jiggling the jelly, cried everyone. No matter how hard she tried, Izzy just couldn't keep still. It's no good, she sighed. I'm just a jiggler and that's that. So when...One day, Class 4B went on a trip to the zoo. It came as no surprise to anyone that Izzy was wriggling, jiggling, shuffling, and fiddling as soon as they walked through the zoo gates. Stop stroking the snakes, called Miss Pathurst. Don't excite the elephants.Forget about bothering the bears. Don't mess with the monkeys. Izzy, stop tapping the tortoises. Stop poking the peacock. And never, ever tickle a tiger. At lunchtime, Izzy sat shoveling her sandwiches.It's so unfair, she said. I'm never allowed to do anything. And what's wrong with fidgeting anyway? Little did Izzy know that she was about to find out. Whilst all the other children finished their lunch, Izzy fidgeted her feet, bounced across the bench, shimmied onto the floor.Wriggled under a bush, skipped past the aviary, and danced along a path all the way to the tiger enclosure. I wonder, thought Izzy, and with that,She reached out a feather and tickled the tiger. Roar! Roared the tiger. He threw his furry paws in the air, which broke a branch.Which startled a snake, who bit a bear, who walloped a walrus, who splashed a sloth, who punched a penguin, who kicked a croc, who snapped at a skunk, who punched a panda, who reined a rhino,who hit the hippo, who wibbled and wobbled and... Splash! Oh. The lion roared. The parrot squawked. The snakes hissed. And the elephants trumpeted loudly. Miss Pathurst squealed.The children giggled, and the zookeeper came running. It was pandemonium, and it was all Izzy's fault. But then, stop! Shouted Izzy at the top of her voice. Stop squealing, squawking, splashing, and flopping. Enough running, roaming, ramming, and bumping. No more jiggling, wriggling, shuffling, and squirming.
Whoa.
And guess what? It worked. The zookeeper stopped running. Miss Potterhurst stopped squealing. The children stopped giggling. And all the animals went back to their homes. And as for Izzy, you were right all along, Miss Potterhurst, she said. I'll never, ever tickle a tiger again. But... what can be the harm of prodding a polar bear, she thought.
Polar bear.
Never tickle a tiger. Hope you enjoy it.